Good day and welcome to D's. Today's topic is systems of equations. In fact, we're going to be doing systems of equations for a while now. And today's goal, I can use the method of substitution to find the solution to a linear system. Now, we found the linear solution to the linear system by graphing in the last note. And basically what we did was we graphed the two lines and we saw where they crossed. But graphing is not an accurate way to solve systems. If the lines don't cross in an exact point, they only give you an estimate of the answer. Plus, if you have them on too big of a scale, you may not see the exact point that they actually cross on. So there's two methods to solve systems using algebra, and the first method is called substitution. And we're going to start off with this rather simplistic equation. This is a system of equations. I have two equations and there are two unknowns. And if I wanted to, I can graph them using a t-axis and an r-axis instead of an x and a y. But we're going to solve it with algebra. So what this equation tells me is that if I take t and I add r, I get 480. And this tells me that t is 15r. Well, my first question to you is that since t equals 15r, why do I bother using a t at all? Why don't I just cross this out and put in 15r instead of using a t? Because it tells me that t is 15r. And that, in fact, is kind of what we're going to do, except we got to write it down a little bit more plainly. Since we are told that t equals 15r in equation 1, it's actually kind of silly to use t at all. So we're going to put 15r in place of the variable t in equation number 1. This way I'm only using one variable. So now we're going to write 15r instead of t plus r equals 480. Now that we've replaced the t, we only have a single variable r, and we know how to solve an equation with one variable. So we need to get an answer for r. So 15r plus r is actually 16r, and that equals 480. And then to get r completely by itself, we divide both sides by 16. And r equals 30. So now we need to figure out what t is. And we're going to figure out t by putting it back into this equation. We know that t equals 15 times r. So we are going to say, since I know that t equals 15 times r, and now I know that r is 30, all I have to do is multiply 15 by 30. To get 450. Now we want to check that to make sure that it works in our other two equations. Let's do just sort of a mental check. Take a look up at the top. It says that t plus r has to equal 480. So 450 plus 30 does indeed equal 480, but this is how we're going to write it down. We want to check that r equals 30 and that t equals 450. So in equation 1, we were told that t plus r equals 480. We're going to do a proper left side, right side check. So on the left side, we're told that we have t plus r. And our t we found to be 450. And our r we found to be 30, which does in fact equal 480. And 480 was what was on the right hand side. And that's what we wanted. We wanted to get them both equal. Left side equals right side. I know I have the right answer. Now I also need to do it in the second equation, just in case I goofed when I plugged it in the first place. So if I have t equals 15r, on the left side of my equation I have t, and that's 450 from what I found. And on the right side of my equation I have 15 times r, which equals 15 times 30, which is also 450. So I can say check, left side equals right side. I got the right answer. Okay, now that was a pretty simplistic one where I had one variable in terms of another already. So I'm going to take a look at this one now. Example 2, solve the following systems. So you see I've got step 1 there, and you should have that on your printout as well. Since we don't have an equation that tells us exactly what y is, we need to rearrange one of the equations to find out. And we're going to call our equation equation 3. Now, notice that this y here in equation 1 is almost by itself. It doesn't have a variable. That's going to be the easier one to solve for because I don't have to divide by anything to get y by itself. And dividing creates places where we get fractions. So you need to look for an equation that has no coefficient, or in other words, the coefficient is 1. So I'm going to take equation number 1 and then get y completely by itself. I'm going to do that by subtracting 3x on both sides. So I have negative y equals 18 minus 3x. And then I've got this negative out here. So I'm going to multiply both sides by negative 1, and I get y equals negative 18 plus 3x. So now I'm going to call this equation 3. And since I know what y is, since y is negative 18 plus 3x, I'm actually going to use negative 18 plus 3x in the second equation instead of y. So in future questions, you should always look for an equation that has a variable without a coefficient and then rearrange to get that variable by itself. So now we're going to use this equation, 5x minus 4y equals 23. That's our equation 2. But we're going to sub y in that place, or sub in place of y, the expression we got, which is negative 18 plus 3x equals 23. So what we put down for communication is sub 3 into equation 2. Now notice I used the equation that I didn't use in step 1, because if I used the equation that I did use in step 1, I'd be subbing an answer into itself, and that gets me nowhere. So now I have to figure this out. This is just a question that you could have done in grade 9. 5x plus 4 times 18 is 72 minus 12x equals 23. Collect like terms and I get 72 minus 7x equals 23. I'm going to subtract 72 on both sides, so I get negative 7x equals 23 minus 72 is negative 49. And now when I divide both sides by negative 7, I get x equals positive 7. So we've solved for the remaining variable x. Now we still have to know what y is, so I have to sub this x equals 7 back into one of the equations I have in the first place. And it can go into equation 1, equation 2, or equation 3. Now equation 3, the one that I rearranged already, this one here, it's the easiest place to sub back into because I already have y by itself. So that's where we're going to put it. We're going to say sub y into 3, or sorry, sub x into equation 3. And equation 3 told me that y equals negative 18 plus 3x. But I know x is 7, so I have negative 18 plus 3 times 7. Follow your order of operations. Don't forget about bedness. Negative 18 plus 21 gives me 3 as a total. So if I had graphed this equation, I would find that these two lines cross at the point 7, 3. So therefore, 7, 3 is the solution. Okay, now I'm going to go through a couple. I'm going to do the left side, right side check on this one. We're checking to see if the point 7, 3 is actually on both these lines. Is it the one that makes it true? And I'm doing it in a t-chart this time. So 3x minus y is on this side. The 18 is on this side, and I don't need to do anything more on the right side of the equation because there's nothing to do. It's just 18. So I do 3. The x that I think I got is 7 minus, and the y is 3. So that's 21 minus 3 is in fact 18. And that means that our left side equals our right side. And we can say, yep, I got the right answer. Now over here, I'm checking the same numbers. I want to see if 5 times 7 minus 4 times 3 actually does equal 23 on this side. So I sub them in, and then I just do the math. This is 34 minus 12 And 34 minus 12, sorry, 35 minus 12 is in fact 23. And so left side does equal right side. I know I got the right answer. So now I'm going to try it with these ones, and you might want to pause the video right now and try it on your own. So I'm going to call this equation 1 and this equation 2. Now I have a choice. I can get x by itself in either of the equations because both of these x's already don't have a coefficient. So I'm just going to pick equation number 2. And I pick equation number 2 because I'm going to have to add 4y to both sides in order to get x by itself. And I like adding a little better than subtracting. So when I add 4y to both sides, I get 4 plus 4y. Now I'm going to take that equation, which I call 3, and plug it back into equation number 1, the equation I didn't use right there. So we say sub 3 in 1. And I have x plus 2y equals 10. But instead of x, I'm going to use 4 plus 4y. And now I just have to solve the way I would have in grade 9. 4 plus 4y plus 2y gives me 4 plus 6y equals 10. Subtract this 4 from both sides, and I get 6y equals 6, and divide both sides by 6, I get y equals 1. Now that I know y is 1, I need to figure out what x is, so I'm going to say sub y into equation 3. I put it into equation 3. I could have put it into 1 or 2, but I'm putting it into 3 because x is already by itself. So I know x is 4 plus 4y, and since I know that y is 1, then x is simply 4 plus 4. Which is 8. And so if I graphed these two lines, they would cross at the point 8, comma 1. So therefore 8, 1 is the solution. Now I'm going to do this one more time. And again, I would suggest that you pause the video and try it on your own. So in this case, I now have a y that's almost completely by itself. It's already got no coefficient. There's no other variable there that doesn't have a coefficient. So that's the one I'm going to solve for. Equation 1, equation 2. So I'm going to say that I'm taking equation 1, which is 2x plus y equals 2, and I'm going to rearrange it to get y completely by itself. So y equals 2 minus 2x when I subtract 2x on both sides. That is my equation number 3. Now I'm going to take that equation number 3 and I'm going to plug it back into equation number 2, which is the equation that I did not use in the first step. So we say sub 3 into equation 2, and I have 3x plus 2y, but y is what I solve for in equation number 3. So I'm going to use the expression 2 minus 2x that I was told y equals up here. And that's going to equal equation number 1. It's going to equal 1 from up here. So now I just need to solve as normal. 3x plus, I need to put that 2 through the brackets, 4 minus 4x, that's going to equal 1. Now I have to collect like terms, so this is going to be 4 minus x equals 1. When I put the 3x and the negative 4x together, I get a negative x. And now I just have to subtract 4 from both sides. So I get negative x equals negative 3, and multiply both sides by negative 1 to get rid of this negative here. I don't want to know what negative x is. I want to know what x is. So x must equal positive 3. Almost done. I'm going to take my answer for x. I'm going to sub x into equation number 3. Equation number 3 says y equals 2 minus 2x, but I happen to know that x is 3. So this is actually 2 minus 6, which is negative 2. So if I graphed these two lines, that I have up here, if I used a table of values or whatever method I want to graph those two lines, they would cross at the point 3, negative 2. So therefore, 3, negative 2 is the solution. You can do a left side, right side check on this too if you want, but I believe that concludes our lesson for today.